So, hello everyone, welcome back to Aviary Attorney. Now, we are currently, we finished up the third case with the trial of Severin Cocorico, and from there are two, well, there are three paths that diverge. So, we are currently going into the case 4B, which is the longest one. And it is going to be the main one. I may, as a bonus video, do case 4A and case 4C, but I will not here say what the requirements are, even though I do know what the requirements are to get these endings. And instead, I leave them, for example, to you, the viewers. If there are viewers, and if the viewers indeed have the wish to play this game for themselves, there are some choices to be made. There are different approaches to be taken, and there are in a surprising twist, there are the three endings. However, we are going into ending 4B, or rather chapter 4B. Those rebels be all like, dang. White people be all like, this isn't due process, and black people be all like, homie being getting kicked by the justice system. Chicken pluckers. There's no time to pull out. There is no time to pull out. Just days away from violence breaking out. It's never a good thing. I guess another revolution might be around the corner. You're not wrong there, but then again, it is France. They do have a revolution every time there's a, shortage of milk or something. You watch far too many action operas. Athletic or historical revolutions center on trials. A nation's rulers are tried and held accountable for their crimes. I suppose so. I mean, not entirely sure it's like always crimes. Just might be incompetence and ignorance. Often it is crimes, though, to be honest. Or at least some fairly nasty shit. The king? So, to the Royal Palace. Act 4B, Egalité. Egalité. Equality. So the three endings are named after the three key principles of the great French revolution, Liberté, Egalité, and Fraternity. So, a private audience after filling in a pile of forms. Those are quite dapper glasses. So a number is 24. More fools who have come to see the king. You, sir, appear to be a vulture. Despite the fact that you do hide your neck quite well in that coat. The Prime Minister! We are here a little bit to offer the king some legal aid, you know. Just a little bit, though. So not even the Prime Minister thinks we'll have a lot of. Well, I say not even the Prime Minister. I assume, you know, the Prime Minister wouldn't. I mean, he'd be in the position of knowing whether or not anything is sensible in these kinds of cases. One would think that seven assassination attempts would be enough for the king to learn that he is, you know, not especially liked. I don't know if you know, detested is such a negative kind of word. Maybe he's just, you know, severely not liked, which is a bit of a more positive spin on the thing. Well, also not quite as honest, but you know, who cares? 24. So now we get to actually go in and have a bit of a thing with the king. And again, loud music signifies an event. So how to start addressing the king? Oh, great and pious ruler. Well, that can go fuck itself. And I don't think listen up will go well. So let's go with the. Let's start nice and go with your majesty. A great evil has besieged your kingdom. There's a storm on. Oh, shit's about to go down. Across the whole city, everyone of every class is getting angry. Mayor's about to go down, yo. Such wild language! As lawyers, we believe that we can help guide the flow of conflict. If you accept our help, we can ensure that this whole event will blow over with the minimum casualties. No public executions, no fires and explosions. That would actually be quite pleasant. That would be good. Also, loud music is loud again. I think I understand. Do you really? A pair of con artists? You have some nerve to even imply that my people hate me. I am the citizen king. I am beloved by all. Originally, I think that actually was the case. Although I'm not quite sure. It might have been that the citizen king actually came to power following a revolution. But I think, I think. What's a weird sharp bit right there? On the king's throat. I think that's under lines. I think that's where the, they've kind of cut the picture to make emoting possible. But it doesn't, always line up properly. So I think that's what, you know, has been bothering me about all these things. I think seven assassination attempts and an impending revolution. Well, apparently we're off to jail now. So once we receive a court hearing, it might be. Might be a few days, or at least. At least days, possibly weeks. So the revolution would, yeah. Yeah, a week. Yeah, there would be people on the streets. Although, you know, people might storm the prison and let you out, so that could also be good. So apparently we must break out of the prison, so those look promising. Neither of us have the physical prowess to shimmy anywhere. Fair enough. I mean, even Sherlock Holmes to accomplish all those feats of weird kind of physical prowess, did actually, you know, do physical stuff. A loose brick. The classic. Let's hide in the jail cell. Seems we are out of options, so escape doesn't seem to be viable. Trying to escape from a notoriously inescapable prison. You know, this is one of those things where kind of, you know, it pays to try. Nothing ever happens before the first time. Being held for treason? That's slightly excessive. I mean, treason is somewhat excessive. I mean, we only offered the king some legal help. It's not like we tried to depose him, although, you know, that might have been fun. Yes, we offered the king our assistance. That's perfectly all right. Well, should be all right at least. I mean, you never know with monarchs. What a pig-headed fool. Oh, thank you. It's good to be friends with Kokoriko, who is the prosecutor, because, you know, a little bit of corruption. A bloodless revolution. So, Cocorico means to charge the king with crimes against the French people before the revolution even starts. So, you know, I think that might actually, you know, be a reasonable plan. King's gluttonous and irreverent fiscal policies, his lack of commitment to his socio-political promises, his overall ineptitude and irresponsibility on all facets. And obviously his denial of universal suffrage. Obviously. Appeal to the king's character. Try to win people's hearts with the tales of the beloved citizen king who's had, well, seven assassination attempts. So, Inspector Volati is missing. And apparently, Inspector Volati, the paragon of virtue that he is, thought that Falcon was some sort of a murderer. He was just another overly opinionated rebel who died in the old revolution. Right, so there appear to be six locations. All of them appear to take the day, so I don't think it matters which one we go, so you know. From the top. For now, we need to find people who've spoken to the king. So we're looking for positive stories about the king. Nothing to say about the king. The king, sir. Go on. Smelly egg thief. Spies everywhere. Why is the king a smelly egg thief? Now we do need the story. So a couple of years ago, these two were running a shop, antiques and odds and ends, and they had an egg. Excellent, golden egg. So bought for 200 francs, but easily worth 10 times that. So what, you had a Fabergé egg, or something to that? Is it the egg that the king keeps in his armpit? An investment egg. I hope you really, really suffer in the end for that pun. So they are visited by the king, and the king shows an interest in the egg. So, So the king stole the egg. And paid with a coin from Britannia. Right, so that's not exactly a positive story about the king. The term is angling. So positive stories about the king. I drag a 90-kilogram falcon out of the water and everyone buys it, but I claim to catch one big fish, and suddenly everyone's a skeptic. Yeah. So, I can actually. So that's not a particularly positive story either. So, well, maybe the library will help. Hello, Nathan. Is the king good leader? So the king has caused a wealth gap, and the king is about as personable as a rotten pear. An expansive history on the Macedonian Empire. Usually returned with footprints on the covers, this leads me to believe that the king may just use them to stand on during speeches. Well, at least he uses them to stand on during speeches and not when he's going potty. No, that is all, unfortunately. Look forward to your next round of idiotic questions. Oh, well, that's nice. Nathan actually appreciates our spirit of inquiry. So the. Oh. I see Judge Maxime has returned. That I find that a little bit weird, but I know that it's a part of the original illustration, you know, bird, human hand with actual fingernails. Robinton. Sparrington. We're bringing down the king, or we're planning a trial of sorts. We are bringing down the king. We are plotting to take down the king of France, he says in a very joyful Oh well. Can't win them all. Just a teenager. So, well, I mean, yeah, it's Falcon's grandfather, and I think. Your grandfather worked so hard to prosecute King Louis XVI, and yet here you are, rigorously working to defend your own king. I wanted to leave his shadow, or I wanted to bring some balance. Well, earlier on, Falcon said that the, you know, it bothered him that others said that he had big shoes to fill, and kind of that he was living in the shadow of of his grandfather, but I think I'm gonna go with the answer of wanted to bring some balance. Show me what the grandson of Maximilian Robespierre is capable of. Casual name drop. Casual name drop, yeah. Yeah, let's just go with, one of the most famous people of the Great French Revolution being a name drop. Just like offhand. Have you ever served the King of France? Don't think so. Well, let's go to the drinking room. We're 78 francs, so, no need to play cards. Although the inspector seems a little bit worse for the drink. No, Falcon, you must listen. I thought you were the Warden Killer. Yes, the Viridian Killer. The man who injured me in the July Revolution. So the reason Valerte came to the conclusion that Falcon might be the Viridian Killer is that Falcon changed his name. Not really. I forgive you for assuming that I am a mass murderer and then for nearly killing me and Severin in order to prove it. It's well done there, Valerte. No wonder the Parisian police is so shit. So we want Valerte to bring the king to the courthouse. You are sympathizers to the rebel cause. So we are now scum. Well, we've had a chat with the inspector now. I mean, that's good. Only one more place to visit, so. Crikey. Positive anecdotes about the king. $10,000? That's a bit much. Between that and Sparrows' medical bills, should be able to afford basic things like food by the year 4000. 1841. I know what it is like to be poor. When I was your age, I only had 1,000 of these to my name. So 20 francs times 1,000 is 20,000. Gave financial advice to the poor and needy. I don't think it is. So, the only place we can go is Aviary Attorney offices. How rude. A large protest has started to form at the Place de la Concorde. The spirit of revolution. We have a king to defend. Yeah, I do hope that's not the egg that the king stole, although I suppose it wouldn't be. At least I hope it isn't. There's a trial you need to attend. The king likes trials. So we get to the courthouse. Did anyone spot us? Too early. It's like going to a music festival. You know, if you get there early enough, the crowds are just forming and you can get a good spot relatively easy. Which, you know, it's nice. Christ, Valerti approaches with the music of righteous indignation. You treasonous scumbags, thank you very much. Very subtle. Yes, we do indeed intend to hold a trial. I've ordered a dozen National Guards to set up perimeter around the entrance. Oh, we actually have a full jury as well. Oh, that's reassuring. Oh, that's me. Oh, that's me. We're simply prosecuting one of you for a short list of 32 crimes. I'm so confused. Yes. Even more confused. Okay, so first charge. Neglecting the lower classes of the nation. Goodness! Well, yeah, the gloves are off, I'm afraid. There's a revolution on the horizon. It doesn't hate poor people, only feels mild contempt for them. Some would. An example of the king being generous to a poor person, so that would be Renard's story. Should we tell the name? I'd rather not. This is not... Oh, that's not good. So, it's outside the royal palace. So they're storming the palace first, which is, you know, fair enough. Is the mighty Officer Beck. And here the trial just steams on. You stand accused of crushing small businesses in favor of supporting wealthier industrial giants. So this would be, Toussaint's story, maybe? Angler, not a fisherman. Yes, let us forget that the king is on trial and let's discuss the fish. What if he had killer bait like a box of iron chocolate? Yeah, it is kind of veering off. Okay, so now the crowds have already reached the Palace of Justice. Hmm. I don't think your people have the skill, equipment, or raw numbers. There's 12 of the National Guard. That means, let's assume that they have a loaded musket and a loaded pistol, so that's 24 shots, after which it's bayonets. So, you know, fair enough. I mean, assuming that they kill and probably actually will kill someone, or at least grievously injure someone with each shot. So that's 24 killed or injured. And then the bayonets, you know, might actually disperse a lot of people, but if the crowd turns in that situation, it's going to be over quite quickly. It's not going to be a happy event for anyone, but, you know. So, last charge. Charge 32. King Louis-Philippe, you are accused of being an imbecile. You are mentally unfit to rule this country. Let's not follow the example of Great Britain, who let the mad King George III rule for decades past his prime. I'll have you know that I'm only competent on prune days. Well, this would be Nathan's story. I mean, the king does check out quite thick books. I had no idea that an expansive history of the Macedonian Empire was a picture book. Probably does have maps and, you know, possibly other drawings as well. Perhaps a test is in order. An expansive history of the Macedonian Empire. Where is Macedonia? Just gonna go with... That's the one that Alexander the Great ruled. Right, so that would mean it's east of Greece? The continent, I'm not quite sure how the borders of the continents go with regards to Europe, Eurasia, Asia, and you know, it's one in the seven shot. Well, it's not the one that Britain filled with criminals. I want to say Africa, but London. Lazy, stupid, and occasionally malicious. He isn't fit to run a bakery. Does the defense have anything to add? Nope. Punishment. Hmm. I mean, on the map, the Notre Dame was quite close to the Palace of Justice, so it's not by any means unreasonable to assume that the catacombs run possibly even under, not just to, but under the Palace of Justice, especially considering that the Notre Dame and the Palace of Justice, according to the map, are on an islet. In 20 seconds, the pillars of the Palace of Justice will fall like the Temple of Dagon. Unfortunately for you, the Viridian Killer emerges one last time. Well, this ending seems rather intent on tying up all the strings. It is true that we did actually try our damnedest with the king, and now it is actually down to the king and, well, down to the judge, of course. So, a verdict has been reached. So, King Louis the Philippe is. And that I assume to be the explosion. Rather unfortunate. So, an explosion right outside. So there are rebels pouring into the building as we speak, which is, you know, to be brutal honest, that's rather unfortunate for us. And we must indeed clear out. Well, yeah, we would actually, yes, we would like to know the verdict. Okay, so the king is sentenced to exile, which I think in this situation is probably the best kind of verdict that could be reached, to be honest. I mean, exile's not so bad. A lot of nice locations, you know, overall. Could have been worse. The rooster does have a point. We're escorting the king to R&M Associates. So we're going to smuggle the king out of the country. I think that's quite good. Probably won't end horribly for us. No time to dawdle and all that. So Cocorico's gonna stay behind and slow down the rebels, which is, you know, quite nice. So, very nice of him, although, you know, kind of worrying at the same time. And again, the music is building up to something truly, and now it's died down again completely. Oh well, you know. Okay, so that had to be settled as well, so. One crippled wolf. I don't think, well, can't know for sure, naturally, but I don't think that is not Renard, is Remus crippled? Kilograms of gunpowder. So Inspector Valerte just went for the. Well, I mean, I think in this situation, it was entirely called for to just shoot Remus without any further questions. I mean, he had already confessed to being the Viridian killer, which means that he already kind of, you know, he was a fugitive from the law and a murderer and all these kinds of things. So, you know, just. Francs is the normal. You know, it's. I don't know. It might be quite a lot, but, you know, it sounds sort of affordable. That is all original yet ordinary, subtle yet exquisite. John Smith. So, this is John Smith, the upstanding English gentleman. Hmm. With that disguise, I think our client will be lucky to make it down the street. But I think he actually will make it to the new world. So, you know, that's good. Or has already made it to the new world. Thinking about it now, you know, actually, yeah, he probably, you know, doesn't make it down the street, considering that the age of exploration is by now so, so very over. Well, it seems like the officers of Aviary Attorney will have quite a lot of work in the future. It's always good to be hopeful. So that has been Aviary Attorney, or at least one of the endings to Aviary Attorney, and it is a very nice game indeed, to be honest. It's a very good point and click game. It doesn't really, it doesn't have puzzles in the way that you know a point and click game usually does. It does have the investigative aspect of the thing down well, and while I don't think that the time management is a factor during the first and the second case as much, definitely not during the first case, might be during the second case, I don't know. It is certainly a thing you kind of have to work around during the last case, so I think that's a kind of a nice increase of difficulty. I have reached the end of Route B. The ending you receive was determined by the decisions you made in Chapter 3. Try tackling the trial in the catacombs differently in order to see a different ending. So that kind of gives it away. So there are three ways the trial in the catacombs, the trial of Severin Cocorico, can go, and the one tackled here is probably by far the hardest to get. But anyway, so that has been Aviary Attorney, and I might do a bonus video on the other two endings, or I might not. Either way, next time it'll be either the bonus video, or that might actually just come out on the following Saturday as a bonus video, and we shall kick off with a new point-and-click game, because, well, I like to play them. They offer me a good chance to, you know, interact with the audience. So, thank you for joining me once again, and for now, goodbye.